up. Yeah, ho. Motherfuckers, if I want you to sing along, it doesn't mean take the mic. Because next one who takes the mic from me, I'm gonna fucking take your teeth. Okay? You can sing along, but don't fucking ruin the show for me. Because then I'll ruin the night for you. How many of you people are old enough to remember when I played here back with Venom at the Metro? How many people remember when I played here with Lost Cause back in the day? Oh shit, how many people remember when I played here with Motorhead? Oh shit, Medusas, the Metro. Love this motherfucking place. The only thing I didn't get done today is I didn't get none of that fucking deep dish pizza, but I guess I'm... This is another one for you, ready? We'll be right back. next song. So wait, let me ask you something. How you like the new material? Come on, you like that shit? It's holding up or what? I'm not trying to live in the past. I'm gonna give you some songs from the past, but I'm not living in the past, you know? This next song, I'm gonna do another new one for you before we start going down memory lane. This next song is about a condition that I suffer from, and I know a lot of you fucking Chicago motherfuckers do as well. It's called PTSD. Take it back about, I don't know, 35 years or some shit like that. Now, I know a lot of you have been through some tough times in life. Nobody owns that story. We all go through some shit. But you know what? If you're still here, that means you never gave up, motherfuckers. So no matter how fucking hard shit gets, no matter how fucking tough life may be, you just gotta keep fighting for that shit. Because you just don't know what lies ahead, man. You just don't know. until you get there. We might be down, but we not out. Feeling alive like a motherfucker. Now, when I was writing these songs back in the old days, you know, when our album, Cassette and all that shit, Cardo album, people keep coming up to me, they're like, damn, man. And I'm writing all these lyrics, and they're like, you got a really negative outlook on life, man. Like, don't you see any hope at all for you, man? You know? And I'm like, look around, man. World peace can't be done. We'll be right back.
burn. You think that you're gone? That's when it's gonna creep it up from me. I ain't not. You try to bring me down. You try to prove. You try to steal my crown. This time you do.
Streets, and this is where we get to the part of the set that stays in the streets for a minute.
Get it!
Now, Chicago, like New York, is a fucking tough city, and I know when I grew up, I did a lot of really fucked up shit because of the environment I grew up in and the people I grew up around, and over time, I've realized You know what? A lot of the shit that I did is because of the things I saw, the stuff that happened to me, and I don't really necessarily believe that violence is the way to go, you know, but I wrote a lot of songs about violence because that's what my life was dealing with. But now, I just want y'all to know that when I sing these songs, I'm not celebrating that shit, I'm not fucking glorifying it. A lot of people thought, you know, Cro-Mag's badass, I'm gonna be fucking hard ass, I'm gonna be a tough guy and fuck people up. But that's not really, if anything, I was the one who was really in pain. And that's why I was taking it out on the rest of the world, because I didn't have a way to process all the shit that had happened to me growing up. And I know a lot of people who made a lot of mistakes and did a lot of fucked up shit, there's things that happened to them that turned them into the motherfuckers that they are. We didn't all start off fucked up. We all started off as babies. You know, it's what happened to us in life that turned us into what we are. But you know what? Even the most fucked up motherfucker can turn their life around. You know, I spent fucking years hiding in drugs and alcohol just trying to deal with the pain that was in here. But it took me a lot of work. And I know that we can all get through this shit. So when I sing these songs, I'm not glorifying unnecessary violence. If anything, it's my confession. It's me fucking spilling my guts. It's me sharing my story and my life. And you guys are kind of like, you know, it's my confession, and you guys are like my therapist. In fact, I was going to therapy for a while because I had so much violent shit that was like replaying in my head every night that I couldn't fucking sleep. It was just like keeping me up. More so the shit that I did to other people than the shit that happened to me, and I just couldn't handle it. But you know what? My therapist quit. And she works with combat vets. She couldn't handle me. So you guys are my therapists, and I thank you for letting me be here. I thank you for letting me spill my guts. I thank you for not judging me, and I try not to judge other people because I know we all go through a lot of shit in life, you know? But you know what? As much as I try to walk with peace, sometimes there's a little need for some street justice.
Justice! 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 Just
Chris, the monitors, please, brother. So yeah, man, I'm sorry it took me so long to make it back here. Thank you. Written a long time ago by me and my best friend at the time, Eric Casanova, and it's wild how two 15-year-olds can write a fucking song like Life of My Own, because those lyrics still mean a lot to me. They mean a lot to me, because you know what, don't fucking worry about nothing else. Nobody fucking, whatever shit they talk, man, you come into this world with nothing but yourself, and that's how you leave. So you just, as long as you die right with yourself, you know, fuck what everybody says. We'll be right back. thank you for the welcome. Thank you for giving me a place to fucking be besides like locked up or sleeping in the gutter. Seriously, man, without you guys, I'd be kind of fucked. Anyway, I just want to say thank you all for coming out, man. Seriously, thank you. I mean it. And we'll be back soon, I promise you. Before we go, fuck St. Mark's. I'm done with it. I just want to say thank you, guys. This is our last song, right? But we will be back soon. I fucking hope you guys, if you take one thing away from this show tonight, it's just that fucking don't ever give up, man. I fucking survived some really fucked up shit in my life. And if I can fucking do it, you can. In 2012, I thought my life was over. Everything fell apart. I was sitting in Rikers Island. My friends fucking set me up. I got fucking jumped. My family broke up. My life was garbage. I was ready to die. You would have killed me then. I would have said thank you for killing me now because I can't live anymore. But I'll tell you right now, I made it through that shit and I know I can make it through anything now. And I don't give a fuck what your fucking struggle is. Even if you're sick, even if you're battling cancer, even if you're fucking, no matter what, fight. Fight for your life, because every motherfucking moment above the dirt is a beautiful thing. I don't care how hard it is. On those days you don't want to get up and you don't want to go to work, those days you don't want to get up and you don't want to do this and this and that and every fucking thing else. Oh, my back hurts, my knee hurts, oh, my dick hurts. You know what? Be grateful you're fucking alive, man. So, yo, gratitude is the attitude, okay? And if there's one last thing I want you to do, make sure that you tell the people that you love that you fucking love them. Because you just don't know when you're going, when your life is going to be over, and you don't know when they're going to be taken from you. So you fucking make sure that they know that you fucking love them. Because that's the most important thing you're ever going to fucking tell somebody in their life. And mean it. Thank you all for being here. Thank you. This is our last song. next year. We'll be back soon, I promise.